See, yesterday we studied the definitions of the trigonometric ratios and the introduction to the trigonometry. And now, today we have to learn the relation among the trigonometric ratios. The relation among the trigonometric ratios. Now, here we have to use the definitions first and we have to write the all the trigonometric ratios in terms of angle P and all the trigonometric ratios in terms of angle R. Here we will represent this angle R by using the Greek letter theta. We will represent this angle R by using the Greek letter theta, or simply we can write sin R, cos R, tan R, but we have to use here a Greek symbol, that is theta. And now we know that in right angle triangle, if we consider this angle R as theta, then the measurement of this angle P, that is equals to 90 minus theta. If the measurement of angle R is theta, then the measurement of angle P becomes 90 minus theta. Since PQR is a right angle triangle, angle Q measures 90 degree. So, sum of the remaining two angles is 90 degree. And if we represent this angle R by theta, then the measurement of angle P is 90 minus theta. So, here using the definitions, we will write all the trigonometric ratios of angle theta, and we have to write all the trigonometric ratios of angle 90 minus theta. So, here we will write all the trigonometric ratios of angle theta. Theta ya angle sathi aapyala sarva trigonometric ratios lihayche ahet. So, first we will write sin theta. As all of you know that the definition of the sin is, the definition of the sine ratio is opposite side upon hypotenuse. The definition of the sine ratio is opposite side upon hypotenuse. So, here we will write opposite side of angle theta. Since we have to write the sine ratio of angle theta, we have to write the sine ratio of angle theta. We have to think about this angle theta. We have to write the opposite angle of theta, that opposite side of angle theta, that is PQ upon hypotenuse. We have to write the hypotenuse into the denominator and it is PR. So, we have sin theta is equal to PQ upon PR. Now, we have to write cos theta. We have 6 trigonometric ratios in all. First, we write sin theta. Then, we have to write cos theta. And the definition of the cos ratio is adjacent side upon hypotenuse. The definition of the cos ratio is adjacent side upon hypotenuse. So, here we have to write adjacent side of which angle? Of angle theta. Since we have to write the value of cos ratio and the definition of the cos ratio is adjacent side upon hypotenuse, we have to write the adjacent side of angle theta. And the adjacent side of angle theta is QR. Adjacent side of angle theta is QR. So, we write here QR upon hypotenuse, and the hypotenuse is PR. So, this is the cos ratio of angle theta. So, we represent it as cos theta. Now, we have to write tan theta. Third trigonometric ratio, that is tan ratio, and here we have to write the value of tan theta. And as all of you know that the definition of the tan theta, the definition of the tan theta is nothing but that is a division of sine and cos, and the definition is opposite side upon adjacent side. The definition of the tan ratio is opposite side upon adjacent side. So, here we have to write the opposite side of angle theta into the numerator. and the adjacent side of angle theta into the denominator. So here we will write opposite side of angle theta. It is PQ upon adjacent side of angle theta, it is QR. So tan theta is nothing but it is PQ upon QR. Tan theta is nothing but it is PQ upon QR. Afterwards, we have to write cot theta, and we know that the definition of the cot ratio, that is multiplicative inverse of tan ratio, definition of the cot ratio is multiplicative inverse, or we can say it as reciprocal of the tan ratio. The definition of the tan ratio is opposite side upon adjacent side. So the definition of the cot ratio is adjacent side upon opposite side. So here adjacent side of angle theta, that is QR, upon adjacent side we write here QR. Now we have to write opposite side into the denominator, that is opposite side of angle theta is PQ, and here we have cot theta is equal to QR upon PQ. Then fifth ratio is sec theta. Fifth trigonometric ratio is sec theta. Here we have to write the value of sec theta. We have to write the ratio, trigonometric ratio, that is sec theta. And the definition of the sec theta is reciprocal of cos theta. The definition of the sec theta is reciprocal of the cos theta. And we know that the definition of the cos theta is adjacent side upon hypotenuse. So the definition of sec theta is hypotenuse upon adjacent side. So here we will write hypotenuse into the numerator. Hypotenuse is PR upon adjacent side. Adjacent side of angle theta is QR. And the last ratio, sixth trigonometric ratio, that is cosec theta. And here we have to write the value of cosec theta, that is equal to, the definition of the cosec theta is the reciprocal of sin theta. We know that the definition of the sin theta is opposite side upon hypotenuse. So we have to write cosec theta as hypotenuse upon opposite side. Here hypotenuse is PR. Hypotenuse is PR upon opposite side, that is PQ. Or simply, we can write the multiplicative inverse, or we can write the reciprocal of this ratio. See, this PQ upon PR is here. So directly we can write PR upon PQ here. While writing the value of sec theta, you can take the reciprocal of cos theta, that is QR upon PR is the value of cos theta. So reciprocal of this is PR upon QR. But we have to make more practice of the definitions. So we have to use the definitions here, and according to definitions we have to put the values there. Now we write all the trigonometric ratios of angle theta. Now we have to write all the trigonometric ratios of this angle 90 minus theta. See, the measurement of this angle P is 90 minus theta, and we have to write all the trigonometric ratios of this angle. So here we have to write first sine 90 minus theta, sine ratio of angle 90 minus theta, sine ratio of angle 90 minus theta. Now we have to write the sine ratio of this angle, angle P, that is 90 minus theta degree. And we know that the definition of the sine ratio is opposite side upon hypotenuse. The definition of the sine ratio, the definition of the sine ratio is opposite side upon hypotenuse. So we have QR upon PR, that is the value of sine 90 minus theta. As we know that the definition of sine ratio is opposite side upon hypotenuse, opposite side of angle 90 minus theta, it is QR upon the hypotenuse. Hypotenuse is PR. Then the next trigonometric ratio is cos ratio. So we have to write the cos ratio of angle 90 minus theta. So we write here cos 90 minus theta. Cos 90 minus theta is equals to, We know that the definition of cos ratio, that is adjacent side upon hypotenuse. See, we learned trick yesterday, that is O A O upon is H H A. This is the trick to remaining the definitions of sine ratio, cos ratio and tan ratio. Those who didn't by heart the formulas or the definitions, they have to use this trick. See, this is the sine ratio, this is cos ratio, and this is tan ratio. Sine, cos and tan. Sine ratio, cos ratio and tan ratio. And then what about cot? Reciprocal of tan. What about sec? Reciprocal of cos. And what about cosec? Reciprocal of sine. And see this, how we remember this trick yesterday. This Obama aya, Obama aya, hato hato me lekar aam. So like this we remember this trick yesterday to know the definitions of the trigonometric ratios. So here the students, those who didn't know the definition of cos ratio, they can see here the cos ratio, how we can write cos ratio adjacent side upon hypotenuse. So here we have to write adjacent side of angle 90 minus theta, that is very important. We are writing the cos ratio, but in which terms of the angle, with reference to which angle we are writing the cos ratio, with reference to angle 90 minus theta. So we have to write the adjacent side of angle 90 minus theta, and this is the adjacent side of angle 90 minus theta is PQ upon hypotenuse is PR. Then we have tan ratio, tan 90 minus theta, tan ratio of the angle 90 minus theta, and we know that the definition of the tan ratio is opposite side upon adjacent side of which angle? Of angle 90 minus theta. Opposite side of angle 90 minus theta, it is QR upon adjacent side of angle 90 minus theta, it is PQ. So this is the value of tan 90 minus theta. Then we have to write cot 90 minus theta. This is cot 90 minus theta is equals to, the definition of the cot ratio is reciprocal of tan, that is adjacent side upon opposite side. So here we have to write the adjacent side of angle 90 minus theta, it is PQ, and the opposite side of angle 90 minus theta, it is QR. Then we have to write sec ratio of angle 90 minus theta, it is sec 90 minus theta is equals to, sec 90 minus theta is equals to, what is the definition of the sec ratio? That is the reciprocal of cos. The cos is adjacent side upon hypotenuse. So sec ratio is hypotenuse upon adjacent side. The definition of the sec ratio is hypotenuse upon adjacent side. The hypotenuse is PR and the adjacent side is PQ. And the last ratio, that is cosec ratio of angle 90 minus theta. So here we have to write cosec 90 minus theta is equal to, now the definition of the cosec ratio is reciprocal of sine. The definition of the sine is opposite side upon hypotenuse. So cosec ratio is hypotenuse upon opposite side. So hypotenuse is PR and the opposite side of angle 90 minus theta, it is QR. And this is the all the trigonometric ratios of angle 90 minus theta. So why we write all these values here? We are discussing about the relationship between the trigonometric ratios. The relationship between the trigonometric ratios in terms of complementary angles. The relationship between the trigonometric ratios in terms of complementary angles. See, this theta and 90 minus theta are the complementary angles. Since the sum of the two angles is 90 degree. So angle P and angle R are the complementary angles, or theta and 90 minus theta are the complementary angles. And we have to study the relationship between the trigonometric ratios in terms of complementary angles. So we write all the trigonometric ratios in terms of angle theta. We write all the trigonometric ratios in terms of angle 90 minus theta. And now we have to observe all these ratios. We have 12 ratios in all. 6 trigonometric ratios in terms of angle theta and 6 trigonometric ratios in terms of angle 90 minus theta. We have total 12 ratios here. And we have to observe all these ratios carefully, and we have to find the relations between the trigonometric ratios. So here, see, if we observe the first ratio, that is sin theta. See, sin theta is equal to PQ upon PR. Sin theta is equal to PQ upon PR. Now we have to observe the value of which ratio in this side. We will represent this as column A and we will represent this as column B. Now in the column A we have sin theta is equal to PQ upon PR. Now we have to observe which ratio has the same value as equal to PQ upon PR. And see this ratio PQ upon PR, this is cos 90 minus theta. This is cos 90 minus theta. It means that these two ratios are equal. See the relation. See, if we represent this as equation 1 and if we represent this as equation 2, the right sides of both the equations are equal. This is PQ upon PR, this is also PQ upon PR. Since both the ratios have their right side equal, so we can represent that their left side are also equal. That is, sin theta is equals to cos 90 minus theta. That is the first relation which we get. Sin theta is equals to cos 90 minus theta. That is the first relation between the trigonometric ratios in terms of complementary angles. For the complementary angles, sin ratio of the one angle is equal to cos ratio of the another angle. That is too easy. If two angles are the complementary angles, then the sin ratio of the first angle is equal to cos ratio of the second angle. Now check the second ratio. See, we have second ratio, that is cos theta is equal to QR upon PR. We have cos theta is equal to QR upon PR in the first column. Now check in the second column which ratio has the same value as that of QR upon PR, and it is this first ratio, sin 90 minus theta. It means that, see, the sin is equals to the sin ratio, sin 90 minus theta is equal to cos theta, or you can represent it as cos theta is equal to sin 90 minus theta. It is too easy. We are here discussing the relationship between the trigonometric ratios in terms of complementary angles, and also we are practicing the definitions of all the trigonometric ratios. Two things we studying here. First thing, that we are practicing the definitions. Yesterday we studied the definitions of all the trigonometric ratios, and today here using that definitions we are writing all the trigonometric ratios in terms of the acute angles. We cannot write the trigonometric ratios in terms of right angle. That thing we have to remember carefully. We can write the trigonometric ratios in terms of acute angles only, not in the term of right angle. That thing we have to think carefully, we have to remember carefully. Now here we have to write the second relation, and that relation is cos theta is equal to sin 90 minus theta. Second relation we have, that is cos theta is equal to sin 90 minus theta. Now see the third trigonometric ratio, tan theta is equal to PQ upon QR. Tan theta is equal to PQ upon QR. Now see in the second column which ratio has the same value, that is PQ upon QR. Which ratio has the same value, that is PQ upon QR. See, this is PQ upon QR and it is cot 90 minus theta. So we can represent that tan theta is equal to cot 90 minus theta. Tan theta is equal to cot 90 minus theta. So here we can write tan theta is equal to cot 90 minus theta. Tan theta is equal to cot 90 minus theta. Next ratio is cot theta, that is QR upon PQ. Now here observe carefully which ratio has the same value, that is QR upon PQ. And see, this is tan 90 minus theta QR upon PQ. So here we can write cot theta is equal to tan 90 minus theta. The value of cot theta is equal to tan 90 minus theta. Next ratio is sec theta. Next ratio is sec theta. The value of sec theta is PR upon QR. Now check in the second column which ratio has the same value as that of PR upon QR. And this is cosec 90 minus theta, that is PR upon QR. Sec theta is equal to cosec 90 minus theta. Sec theta is equal to cosec 90 minus theta. And now we have last ratio, that is cosec theta. The value of cosec theta is PR upon PQ. Now in this column only one value is remaining, that is sec 90 minus theta, and it is equal to PR upon PQ. So both these ratios are equal. So here you can write cosec theta is equal to sec 90 minus theta. Cosec theta is equals to sec 90 minus theta. Here we get all the relations between the trigonometric ratios in terms of the complementary angles. The sine ratio of the first angle, we have two angles and both the angles are complementary angles of each other. Complementary angles means two angles having some 90 degree. Complementary angles means two angles having some 90 degree. If we take the sum of these two angles, theta and 90 minus theta, then it is equal to 90 degree. So these two angles are said to be complementary angles. And now in terms of the complementary angles, sine is equal to cos and cos is equal to sine. See, this is very easy. Sine is equal to cos and cos is equal to sine, but when? In terms of complementary angles only. In terms of complementary angles only, sine is equal to cos and cos is equal to sine. Sine is equal to cos and these two angles are the complementary angles. And cos is equal to sine, here these two angles are the complementary angles. It is possible only when we have given the two angles and the two angles are the complementary angles. At that time only it is possible sine is equal to cos and cos is equal to sine. See this. Same thing is here, tan is equal to cot and cot is equal to tan. For the complementary angles only, tan theta is equal to cot 90 minus theta or cot theta is equal to tan 90 minus theta. Simply we can remember tan is equal to cot or cot is equal to tan in terms of complementary angles only. It happens only when if these two angles are the complementary angles, tan ratio is equal to cot ratio and cot ratio is equal to tan ratio for the complementary angles only. And see these two ratios, structure is very important. The structure is, see, we have three pairs, sine cos, tan cot and sec cosec. Sec is equal to cosec and cosec is equal to sec, but when? In terms of complementary angles only. If the two angles, and see, this is right angle triangle, we have a right angle, so definitely remaining two angles are the complementary angles only. If a triangle is right angle triangle, then definitely the other than right angle remaining two angles are the complementary angles of each other. Since sine ratio of this angle is equal to cos ratio of this angle, cos ratio of this angle is equal to sine ratio of this angle, tan ratio of this angle is equal to cot ratio of this angle, cot ratio of this angle is equal to sine ratio of this angle, and sec is equal to cosec, and cosec is equal to sec for the complementary angles only. So how to use these formulas, where we have to use these formulas? Sometimes question is there, see sine 20 degree, sometimes you have question in exam, that is sine 20 degree is equal to dash, sine 20 degree is equal to dash. Now we know that sine is equal to cos for the complementary angles only. If we have sine 20 here, then definitely we have to write here, see sine is equal to cos. In terms of complementary angles, sine is equal to cos. Here we have 20 degree. So, complementary angle of 20 degree is 70 degree. Complementary angle of this 20 degree is 70 degree. 20 and 70, the sum is 90. So, 20 and 70 are the complementary angles of each other. So, here we write cos 70 degree. Sometimes we have multiple choice questions like that. We have given the four options and you have to select the one proper correct option. At that time, we have to use these identities. Sine is equal to cos, cos is equal to sine. Tan is equal to cot, cot is equal to tan. Sec is equal to cosec, and cosec is equal to sec in terms of complementary angles. Now, suppose I write here, since cot 35 degree, cot 35 degree, and here we have empty space. So, what we have to write there in the empty space, and it is, see if we have cot ratio here, then definitely we have tan ratio here. This tan is equal to cot and cot is equal to tan. Sin cos, tan cot, sec cosec, we have three pairs, pair of first and second, pair of third and fourth, and pair of fifth and sixth. Sin is equal to cos, cos is equal to sin. Tan is equal to cot, cot is equal to tan. So, we write cot is equal to tan. Here we write tan. Now, see 35 degree. First angle is 35 degree. Now, what should be the second angle? That should be 55 degree. So, subtract this 35 from 90. As the sum of these two angles 90 degree, these two are the complementary angles. If these two angles are complementary angles, at that time only cot is equal to tan or tan is equal to cot, otherwise it is not possible. So, we have to write the complementary angle of 35 degree here, and it is 55 degree. So, we can write cot 35 is equal to tan 55. As the sum of these two angles is 90 degree, they are complementary angles of each other. We will take one more example. Suppose I write here sec 75 degree, then that is equal to, see if we have sec ratio in left side, then definitely right side has cosec ratio, because sec is equal to cosec and cosec is equal to sec for the complementary angles. If we have sec ratio here, we have to write cosec ratio. Now, if you have 75 degree here, subtract this 75 from the 90 to get the measurement of the second complementary angle. This first angle is 75 degree. How much plus 75 is equal to 90? That is 15 degree. So, we write here cosec 15 degree. So, this is all about the relationship between the trigonometric ratios in terms of complementary angles.